हेलो एवरीवन एंड वेलकम टू आईवीएसए बीदर्स ऑफिशियल यूट्यूब चैनल पशुवाणी। पशुवाणी इज अ प्लेटफॉर्म दैट प्रोवाइड्स यू विद वेटरनरी एजुकेशन। आर वीडियो सीरीज कंसिस्ट्स ऑफ प्रैक्टिकल रेलेवेंट लेक्चर वीडियोस, फील्ड अप्रोच क्लिनिकल एस्पेक्ट्स, गाइडेंस टिप फॉर फ्यूचर करियर्स, स्मार्ट कंटेंट रिलेटेड टू बोथ एनिमल एंड वेटरनरी साइंस। वी बिलीव शेयरिंग इज केयरिंग, सो प्लीज लाइक, कमेंट एंड सब्सक्राइब फॉर फर्दर अपडेट्स। एंड नाउ Let's welcome a speaker of today's episode of Saturday's Sharing.
Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Srikant Dodmani, working as Assistant Professor in the Department of Animal Genetics and Breeding, Veterinary College, Bidar, Karnataka. So today we will be discussing regarding NBAGR. So this NBAGR is the National Bureau of Animal Genetic Resources, which is a premier institute in the country, which deals with giving recognition to the breeds. So the contents of today's topic are establishment of NBAGR, objectives, breed definition and status, accession number, website, that how to serve the website of NBAGR, that is www.nbagr.res.in, then recently registered breeds of different species, the National Gene Bank. So this NBAGR is nothing but it is the nodal agency that gives recognition to the Indian breeds of both livestock and poultry, right? Then coming to this ANGR, ANGR is nothing but it is the Animal Genetic Resources of India. It means that whatever the existing livestock and poultry breeds of our country is having, it is called as the Animal Genetic Resources of India. Likewise, every country is having its own ANGR, that its own Animal Genetic Resources. Then coming to the establishment of this NBAGR, so it is the premier institute, right? So first it was established in the year 1984 on 21st September at Bengaluru in the form of the twin institutes, namely the National Bureau of Genetic Resources and National Institute of Animal Genetics. So later on in the year 1985, the twin institutes got shifted to Karnal, Haryana. Then in the year 1995, both the twin institutes got merged to a single entity in the form of National Bureau of Animal Genetic Resources. So what we call it as NBAGR, right? So it is located in the Karnal, Haryana. Then coming to the objectives of this institute. So it deals with the identification, evaluation, characterization, conservation and utilization of the livestock and poultry genetic resources of the country. It means that it deals with giving recognition to the breeds. So coming to the classification of the biodiversity, that is where the breed is located in the classification of the biodiversity. So this breed is presided by the species, genus, family, order, class, phylum, kingdom and the domain. So this is just for your information. Then coming to the actual definition of the breed. So breed is said to be the group of animals having the same phenotypic and the genotypic characters belonging to a specific geographical area and they breed true to type. So breeding true to type is nothing but offsprings resembling the parents, right? So breeding true to type is nothing but their offsprings will resemble the parents, right? So coming to the status of the breeds, status of the Indian breeds. So this is the present status, that is the year 2020. So the total existing Indian indigenous breeds are 197. Right. So among this 197, we have 50 cattle breeds, 17 buffaloes, 34 goats, 44 sheep, 7 horses, 9 camel, 10 pigs, 3 donkeys, 1 yak, 19 chicken, 2 ducks and 1 geese. So this is the present status of ANGR of India. So totally we have 197 Indian indigenous breeds belonging to different species. Then, coming to the accession number. Likewise, the every student who gets admission in the new course in the new colleges, he gets his own ID number, right? So still he finishes his course, so he will be known by that ID number. Likewise, every new breed that is recognized by this NBAGR is given an ID number. So this ID number is called by the name called as the accession number. Right? So this accession number is nothing but it is an alphanumeric code that has been designed for all the breeds in the following format. So the format of the accession number is India, species name A, B, C, D, then breed name, then X, Y, E, F, G. So we'll see how it works. So India, then species name, then AB. AB stands for the two-digit numeric code for the state 1, which is its major breeding tract. Then CD, it stands for the two-digit numeric code for the state 2. Then XY, two-digit numeric code for the species. Then EFG, it is a three-digit numeric code for the breed. So let me explain this concept of accession number using these examples. For example, Dioni is a breed. It is a recognized breed which is belonging to two states, that is Maharashtra and Karnataka, right? So if you follow this format of the accession number, so India followed by the species name. So Dioni is a cattle, so cattle species. Then AB, this 11 stands for AB, that is the two-digit numeric code, right? So Maharashtra, so every state is given a specific code during giving the recognition to the breeds. So 11 is the major breeding tract of this breed, Dioni breed. So 11 represents Maharashtra. And as this Dioni is belonging to Maharashtra and Karnataka, so CD stands for, that is 08, it represents CD, which is the two numeric code belonging to state 2. 08 is the designated code for Karnataka. Then comes the breed name. After ABCD, we have the breed name. So what is the name of the breed? It is Dioni, right? Then XY. XY stands for the two-digit numeric code for the species. So 03XY. So the numeric code that we have assigned for the cattle is 03. Then comes EFG, that is 005. It represents EFG. It is the three-digit numeric code for the breed. So 005. It means that it is the fifth cattle. Dioni is the fifth breed that has been recognized under the category of cattle species, right? So this is how you have to read the accession number. So let me take the other example, Murra, which is a buffalo breed. So India, then comes the species name, buffalo, then 05. 05 is AB, which represents the major breeding tract. So 05 is the state code assigned for Haryana. So it is seen only in the one state. So CD, we write it as 00. Then comes the breed name Murra, right? Then XY is the numeric code applied for the species. So buffalo is given 01 code. Then EFG, 001 is the EFG, which is the three-digit numeric code for the breed. So 001. Means that it was the first buffalo breed that was given recognition, right? So this is how you need to read the accession number. So every breed that has been recognized by the NBAGR is given this unique accession number. So it has been represented by its unique ID, what we call it as the accession number, right? Then coming to understanding the website of this NBAGR. So the official website of this NBAGR is the website address is www.nbagr.res.in. Right? So this is the official website. Then, how to track the breeds? How to track the breeds or how to know the status of breeds? So it is the only official website, right? So this NBAGR is the only official institute. It is the only nodal agency that gives recognition to the breeds, the Indian breeds. So any information that you need to know regarding the breeds, so the only website that you need to refer is www.nbagr.res.in, right? Now, so if you look into the left side of the page, right? So you have an portal here. So like the Animal Genetic Resources of India, that is Agri IS. So when you click on this Animal Genetic Resources of India, that is Agri IS, then you'll get a page like this. We'll get a screen like this, which shows you the different species, then the different breeds available, right? For example, if you want to know some cattle breeds, then in the available species column, just click on the cattle, then whichever breed you want to know, the information of the breed that you are interested, so you just click on it, then give submit button, then press the submit, then so the information of that breed is displayed now. So you have the photo section. If you click photo option, then you will get the original picture of the breed that you have selected, then you will get its information in this format, right? So whatever the information is there in this website, it is the true information regarding that particular breed, right? Then coming to the newly registered breeds of the different species in the year 2020. So there are 7 newly registered breeds of cattle in this year, right? So the first one was the Podu Turupu. It belongs to Telangana and it has given its own accession number. So just observe the last digit 44. So what does it mean? So it is the 44th cattle breed that has been recognized, right? Then comes Nari. It belongs to Rajasthan and Gujarat, right? So now observe this 7904. So 17 is the code given to Rajasthan and 04 is the code given to Gujarat. Then 45, right? This EFG045 is the breed code. It means that it is the 45th animal breed that has been recognized, right? So when you observe here 3600, so 36 is the code given to Telangana. It belongs to only Telangana state. So the other state is not available, so we write it as 00, right? Then comes the Dagri, belonging to Gujarat, right? So again, here you observe Rajasthan and Gujarat. So the state code for the Gujarat is 04. So we write here it as 04. As it is belonging only to Gujarat, the second state code will be written as 00, and it is the 46th breed to be recognized. Likewise, we have Toto belonging to Nagaland, Shweta Kapila belonging to Goa, Himachali Pahari belonging to Himachal Pradesh, and Purnia belonging to Bihar. So this Purnia, which is belonging to Bihar, is the 50th cattle breed that has been recognized, which has been recently recognized. So these are the 7 cattle breeds that have been recently recognized by NBAGR, right? Likewise, in the year 2021, there may be some more additions, right? So every updated information regarding the breeds, you have to surf this website. It means always you need to visit this website to get the updated information regarding the newly registered breeds. Then in this year, we have one buffalo that has been recognized, called as Gojri, belonging to Punjab and Himachal Pradesh. So it is the 17th breed that has been recognized. Then sheep, we have Kajli, belonging to Punjab. than pigs, two pigs have been recognized. One is Mali, belonging to Tripura, and Purnia, belonging to Bihar. So both cattle and pigs, they have given the same name, that is Purnia, which is belonging to Bihar. Then donkey, we have Kachi, belonging to Gujarat, and duck, we have Maithili, belonging to Bihar. Then chicken, one variety they have developed, strain, that is PD2, right? So this PD2 was developed by PDP Hyderabad, right? So these are the recently registered breeds. So those students who are preparing for the competitive exams and other JRF and SRF exams, so what type of questions you will get with regarding to breeds is, they may ask you the total availability of the breeds in India and the recently registered breeds and their states, right? So this point you need to be remembered. Then just at a glance, so the total Indian cattle breeds, so whatever the 50 cattle breeds we are having, they are again classified into three categories. So this classification, we call it as the classification based upon the utility. So the first classification is milch breeds, then comes the draught, then comes the dual purpose breeds. So which breeds are called as the milch breeds? So milch breeds means they are meant for the milk purpose. Their milk yield is higher. So those breeds whose milk yield is more than 1600 kgs per lactation, so those breeds are grouped under the milch breeds. They are called as milch breeds or the milking breeds. Then comes the draught breeds. Draught breeds means they are meant for working. They are meant for agricultural operations. So their milk yield will be less than 500 kgs per lactation, right? So their milk yield will be less than 500 kgs per lactation, and they cover the walking distance of 5 to 7 kilometers per hour, covering 30 to 40 kilometers per day. This is the walking distance. Then comes the dual purpose breeds, whose milk yield is more than 500 kgs but less than 1600 kgs, and they are fit for even the draught work, hence they are called as the dual purpose breeds. So we get both milk and we can extract the draught work from this group. Then this NBHER will give you the official calendars of the different species. Like, so this photo you might have been seen your class laboratories, right? So this is the calendar that has been given by the NBHER, right? So this is the cattle breed, the calendar of the cattle, then the buffalo calendar we have, then comes the goat calendar, then sheep calendar, and the chicken calendars. So coming to the next concept, that is National Gene Bank. So this National Gene Bank, which is located at the bureau, that is at the NBHER, has been established with the objective of conserving the indigenous livestock biodiversity. So conserving the indigenous livestock biodiversity. So this National Gene Bank, it deals with the conservation of the indigenous livestock biodiversity. So what does it mean? So it deals with preserving the semen samples. It deals with the cryopreservation of the semen, right? So it forms the real asset, right? So presently, a total of 2,27,363 deep frozen semen doses belonging to 459 breeding males, right? So these males includes males of bulls, rams, bucks, and stallions from 47 breeds representing cattle, buffalo, sheep, goat, camel, yak, and equine have been collected and preserved at the gene bank for the prosperity, right? So breeds whose semen is cryopreserved at NBHER. So total 25 cattle breeds, their semen have been cryopreserved at the gene bank. Then, so total 12 buffalo breeds have been cryopreserved, that is their semen samples have been cryopreserved. Then coming to goats, we have 5 goat breeds, that is Black Bengal, Chigu, Osmanabadi, Assami and Gaddi have been stored here. Then equines, 3 equine breeds, Marwari, Zanskari and Poitou. Then sheep, the Garol sheep, you know, it is known for the twinning. Then comes the one yak, that is the Arunachali breed. So, coming to the conclusion of today's topic. So, NBIGR is the only nodal agency which gives recognition to breeds of the different species in India, right? So, give a regular visit to this website to get the updated information of ANGR of India, because every year the newly registered breeds, their number will be keep on updating. So every year you need to visit this website and get updated regarding the ANGR of India, that is the Animal Genetic Resources of India. So this was all about the today's topic. So thank you.